Tell us about your experience with contact with the White House, with the president, with the vice president.
At the dignified transfer in Dover, I was extremely honored to have had Vice President Pence there. He spent a great deal of time talking to me, and it wasn't an uncomfortable type of thing. He really was just a very genuine human being, and he shared his condolences, and he talked to me like he knew me forever, so it meant a lot for me to have him there. Soon after, maybe it was around the same time, I know that I was meeting with my casualty officer, and he received a call from the White House. I'm not exactly sure who, but he was told that I needed to be by my phone for the next few days because the president would be calling me to express his condolences on behalf of the nation, and I never received the phone call.
What would it have meant to have received the phone call?
I think for me, I'm kind of neutral on the topic. Just having the extreme outpouring of support and condolences and just my support system in general and the reaching out of all kinds of military officials and government officials, I knew that Jonathan's sacrifice was appreciated, and I knew that the condolences were sent out to me, so it was very genuine. But my issue is having all of the support I had was great, but not receiving the phone call, I don't like that I was told that I would receive the phone call, but then I never did.
What would you have wanted to hear from President Trump?
Just knowing that it was appreciated, and not necessarily appreciated isn't the word. There's not really an appropriate word. Just knowing that he was grateful for the sacrifice of my husband and for Christopher Harris, and just hearing that, it would have been a tremendous honor to have heard that directly from the president.